So I sleep deeply in my mom's room when she's not home. When she goes places, when she's at church. I sleep deeply, but I don't sleep like comfortably. This is definitely a soft mattress that she picked out with Auntie a few years ago. I still have the receipt somewhere. I remember seeing it when I was going through my hundreds and hundreds of receipts. Speaking of which, I need to return some of that makeup. Still need to mail back those sneakers. Remember I exchanged them. But to exchange, I had to actually buy, unless I wanted to wait for weeks for the new other ones, the purple ones, I just, you know, buy them again, and then I'll get a full refund of these ones. Anyway, you two baby, I'm in love. I do. I sleep deeply. But the reason that I sleep deeply is simply because my mom's door locks. And I know that I can be in here and just... The only way she can disturb me is if she... knocks on the door, which I very perplex, so I barely hear her knocking on the door, you know. Whereas when I'm on the couch, she can disturb me at any time, you know. I like... I mean, I lock that door even when I know she won't be home for hours. I like to feel just all enclosed, you know. I can feel how this mattress sinks in right here. That's just not good. And it's not an old mattress, only a few years old. I didn't like it from day one. I did not like it. And since we have clearly demonstrated how my aunt discards my mom, I have my doubts that my mom got to like take time to try out mattresses and figure out what she liked and things like that. I doubt they spent a day like searching for the best mattress or whatnot, the best bed. I say that not knowing, I just say that just based on other things. In any case, the bed was not even remotely cheap. And I didn't like it from day one. It was too fucking soft for me. And I can feel how it goes in right here. It's up here and indented here. I can feel it. I wake up achy. I didn't turn the TV on in here last night after I created the video for you guys. I just fell asleep and I woke up. I'm under the bed and I'm on the couch and I cried myself to sleep. I went to sleep. But these people didn't do anything to my mom, you know what I mean? They didn't break. even if it can be attributed to her illness. My mom is the one who dug my grave and put the coffin in. The two women around here, I thought, cared about me. First, godsend woman, and then, a million times worse, a woman I most definitely viewed as a friend. You know, that thing I have so few of. Joe and Selena are far, far away. You know, she and that godsend woman, they piled on the dirt, but I was already in the coffin, in the ground. My mom had already shoved the coffin in the ground, say, my coffin. And my grave. So Selena, I wish I hadn't known it was the woman who hadn't said anything to me. My mom was there too. She doesn't understand what's going on. She doesn't understand. She wasn't, you know. She cries when she hears what happened to me, but it starts with what she did to me. And she was in the regular hospital on the way to the mental hospital. Laura, I don't love you. I will never forgive you for this. I walked out of her door and crumbled. Two nurses saw me. They had heard because the door was open. I wasn't allowed to be in there alone with her. And she knew, I guess. She was being medically cleared, but there was something medically before she could go to mental hospital, to my recollection, and she had someone with her at all times, so that someone was nice enough to step out of the room, but still couldn't leave my mom alone. That was her job. She gave us privacy, if you want to call it that, but she could still hear, you know. So when I stepped out and they saw the tears streaming down my face, she's like, I heard the entire thing. She didn't mean it. You know, the nurse tried to comfort me to no avail. Broke my foot, and I knew if I broke down after being rejected first by God's woman and then by, like I said, a mental towards my woman I had viewed as a friend, not as an acquaintance, not as someone that, you know, would be nice and drive me places here or there or whatnot. Friend. Survival mode. You know, just like when I had to live on the streets, LA with my marker that week, back in 12, that was survival mode. Nothing mattered to me but a mark, you know, my safe. It's just me. I wanted to crumble to the ground and start screaming and never stop and be locked up. I had to stay strong for a while. Then when I broke my foot, oh my God. chose a walker instead of crutches, as some of you know, because there would be much less chance of something, you know. But Omar still got underfoot, and a lot of times I pissed myself because I could, he was in my way, and I'd wake up, and it takes time to get up and get onto the walker, and I had to worry about him getting in my way, and you know. As hell. I need no one to help me. Selena says, wouldn't you rather know? Isn't it better for you to know? No, it isn't. It's not better. I had no plans of ever being friends with this woman. Can't you put my heart a million times over? God, said woman at least gave me a cold explanation. She could have been nicer about it. But then I find out all these years later, she ordered my friend to not to do the same damn thing to me, but the friend was too ashamed or too whatever. She wasn't gonna say, I'm sorry, Laura, I can't have anything to do with you. She took the easy way out. She just avoided me. She just didn't return my texts or calls. And at first, I was in such shock. I'm like, please, I'm begging you, Mary. I'm begging you. I just want to know you're okay. Nothing. Nothing. It's just sick. That woman said I was in. Church woman came through for me. Of course, didn't want to ask her for anything. She's my mom's friend. And you know, my mom's not in my life anymore. What do I want to be? Desperate times. But she couldn't help me with Omar. She can't. She's allergic. Second was hell. Because Omar was blind. And Selena said, and she was just making a joke, but she was like, my God, it's like a movie. Crippled woman, you know, temporarily. But I mean, and a blind dog. I mean, it was hell. One wrong move, and that was it. There was nobody to take care of my dog. He would have been dead. No doubt in my mind. I couldn't take care of myself in this house. And I would have been removed from the house if I had broken down, if I couldn't, you know. Would have been taken from me, and not likely people. Maybe would have been, not likely he would have been, being that old blind dog. I don't think he would have been adopted or whatever, but I still would have not had him. Then I would have no mom, have no Omar, you know. Of course, my mom doesn't want to hear any of this. What do you know, she has to understand why I had to get away from that woman, why I basically had didn't exactly make a scene, but I was breaking down and I had to get away. I was tearing up. I needed to call something. Selena, not Joe, because Joe would just be like, you know how people are, Laura, you know, it's just, I call Selena. I was fortunate enough that she answered, and she knew the whole story from before. I asked to Joe, but Joe would just say, remember Joe? It's just on a different level, you know. Joe believes extraterrestrial beings are running the whole show. The Anunnaki, the Archons. I just don't want to hear that kind of shit, and I just want to focus on this reality, even if everything Joe believes is true. So, who am I to say if it is or isn't true? Well, I know that Christians could be right, and I could be destined to burn in hell for all eternity. Force myself to believe something that I believe. That's the whole thing. The earplugs though. And in here. With the earplugs and out there on the couch at my own, no, but if I'm hiding, if I'm like all in this little cocoon with the door off, and I even put a blanket thing down, I don't hear shit. I can sleep in here and my mom could be out there and I don't hear anything. It's great. This bed where my pant right here is further away, I think, from it. Because when I'm in my bed, in my room, I will sometimes hear her. She's talking on the phone because she gets kind of loud. But it's still muffled, you know. This is further away from that door from where she'd be talking, of course, in the living room. Whereas my room's right there, and the box room mattress in my head is right there, and that's just right down though. It's just closer. That makes a difference, you know. just so happy. He's so happy just to not be in the crate. Does so well, even if that's it. Mom does really well under his seat. He doesn't seem to be in any pain. He doesn't, you know, it's like I didn't know I got a call from the vets. But I heard his vet. And she's like, just calling to see if Mom was alright. And he's fine, he's great. Bitch nap to have to heat up his food, and his dry food takes forever to turn soft. I need to do it ahead of time for the day. I want to be boiling that food 3 or 4 times a day. It's tedious and it doesn't work. It takes forever on the stove and microwave. I keep pressing the button on the stove. It doesn't. Get comfortable and take my breath and all that. I slept in my clothes because overnight I slept in my clothes because I was drinking a little bit. Didn't wind up drinking as much as I was gonna though because I changed my mind about going out. And then there's a possibility after church we're gonna go somewhere in church room. That didn't happen, so. I did shower and wash and grab my hair yesterday. And I was like, oh, your hair's so beautiful. My hair looks really good when I blow dry it, you know, like it's great. She feels bad what she did to me. She said as much. She also said as much after I broke my foot. She waited a long time, and it's not like she didn't make an effort. She didn't, you know, come knock on my door and apologize. She saw me walking. Can I talk to you? And I wanted to tell you what happened. But I remember, I said to her, you broke my heart. This was, you know, a couple of years after I broke. And she was like, it wasn't my fault. And at that time, I thought, but there's no excuse. Even if you were going through a rough time, you just let me know, Laura, I'm going through a rough time. I can't deal with your problems right now. And I think that's okay. I still love you. Now I find out it wasn't her fault because she was ordered. That's bullshit. When you're in the United States, you are not in fucking uniform. She knew I could order her to not be my friend. Peer pressure. Sounds like, what, are you in kindergarten? But actually, that's more like high school peer pressure from junior high, or okay, you can't like her because I don't. You need to stick with me. We're gonna ostracize Laura and Omar so that they die, you know? And then we're gonna smile at them like we did nothing wrong. But after their foot's no longer broken, and you know I don't do phony. I'd rather be alone. Joe's a loner too. We've both talked. We've resolved ourselves. We're just gonna be alone forever. This is not worth it. But I keep trying. I think friends are worth it, and then I get screwed over and keep getting proof that I'm a goddamn fool to believe in. Actually, genuinely cares about me.